Howdy, everyone. We're going to do something a little bit different today. We're still going to talk about AI and agents, and we've had a lot of conversations about that. But when we start thinking about AI and AI identities, there's actually some open questions that are still being debated out amongst companies and out in the industry. So I want to pose a set of questions today and engage everyone in feedback and comments so that we can actually have an open bit of a conversation about some of these questions and invite you to give me your thoughts on how you think are going. I don't want to make this a debate. I really am not looking for, you know, people to chime in with that you really are against something. I really am inviting everybody to just have an open conversation and think about some of the questions that are actually being posed out now about agents and agentic identities. All right, before we get to that, I do want to revisit a little bit about identities and set that up as kind of a foundation for our questions on our conversation. So the first thing I want to talk about is humans and how we are represented as identities in corporations. Now, first thing we have to understand, and this one is obvious, is that we have a physical existence. We are here in a physical world in organizations performing tasks and jobs, right? So we actually have a physical existence. Now, and I kind of just said this, the next thing that we have is we belong to organizations. So we belong to an enterprise or a company, we belong to a department, we belong to a business unit, but we do belong in some way to an organization within an enterprise. The next thing is I want to start thinking about how we perform tasks. So as employees, we perform tasks. And so the first thing that we typically do is we're given a task and we have to assess what it is that I'm supposed to do. And once we assess it, we actually start breaking down the problem into a set of steps, especially for complex tasks. Like, okay, what is it that I need to do? What are the steps that I need to take? Once we've assessed the problem or the task, not a problem, and we break that down, the next thing we do is we execute. We actually perform the task. And then finally, we come back and we learn, all right, did that work? How did I do with the task? Could I have done it better? Is there something I wanted to change? And we learn from that and we apply that the next time we do a task. All right, so that's humans. The next thing is our traditional non-humans, or what we call NHIs, non-human identities. Now, they're a little bit different. Obviously, they're digital. They have a digital existence, and traditionally, they also, when they perform a task, they're very deterministic. We know exactly what they're going to do and how they're going to do that, and it is typically unvarying, right? We really don't change how a non-human entity or identity works. It does the task. So now let's think about agents. So we've been talking about agentic flows and agentic systems. I'm not going to talk about assistants. Really want to leave this to agents. When we think about AI and we think about agents, now first, obviously, they're not physical, right? They're digital, just like other non-human identities. But we really largely think they're going to belong as part of an organization. They're going to be in a business unit or a department performing tasks. And when they do perform a task, they're going to assess. This is really what we're trying to do with AI and with agents. They look at what the prompt or the ask is. They assess what it is. They break it in down into tasks. How am I going to orchestrate this flow? How am I going to perform the steps that I need? They execute on that flow, and then they actually learn. We actually will retrain them. We'll look, what was the accuracy of the task they performed? Was it 70%? Was it 80%? Was it 90%? If it wasn't high enough, we'll go back and learn. So in this case, they really start operating and behaving a lot like a human. And so when we talk about that then, so as we start embracing agents into a workplace, there are questions that start arising around that. And so these are the questions that I want to pose to everyone to kind of chime in and give me your thoughts on this. The first one is, when we think about agents, is our agents just software? Now, obviously they are, right? We say they're digital. We know that they're living in IT systems, and there are actually applications that we have running. But they're also learning, and they're assessing, and they're thinking about tasks. And so while, yes, they are just software, they're also kind of more. They're somewhere starting to behave the ways that humans would behave when they're taking on tasks. And that's the artificial intelligence piece of this, right? So the question is, are agents, are they just software? Is that just, are we just going to look at them like traditional non-human identities and applications, and like that's all it is, right? So that's the first big question I have. The second question then is, should we or do we recognize agents as coworkers? Now, this is actually a point of a lot of debate. There's a good use case from a year or so ago where an organization actually treated them from an HR perspective as an agent was just another worker. And there was actually, you know, some documented things about that didn't really work out so well from a human, you know, from an HR perspective. But this is not that. This is not the question I'm asking here. This is, if an agent is performing tasks for an organization, for a business unit, should we treat them like they are just another coworker? And part of the reason I ask that is, if we think about a case where we have agents that are supplementing or extending, virtually extending a support team, and they're going to pick up and do tasks similar or maybe even the same way that a human would process support and find answers and report on those answers, if we're virtually treating them like a workforce, do we recognize them as a coworker? So this is the next question that I pose to everyone is, do we recognize them as a coworker? The third question that I really want to ask then is, and it's, all of these are very much related, but should an agent, do we put an agent into the directory? And, you know, this can be your Active Directory, it could be an Enterprise Directory, it could be a lot of things. And the reason I pose this question is, one of my earlier videos, we were talking a lot about agentic identities and governance, and one of the comments actually came and said, please don't tell me that we're now going to put agents in the Active Directory. That's actually the question. Should we be doing that? Should we be putting, if they're coworkers, if we think of them as supplementing our workforce because they're performing tasks similar to the way we do it, should they be in the directory? So I pose that question out to everyone. The next question I'd like to ask is, are agents, are they persistent? Or ephemeral? In other words, me as a human worker, I have a physical existence, right? So I'm persistent. I come to work, I am there, and I perform the tasks that are coming my way. Agents can actually be, back to the first question, if we, you know, they are software, so we can actually, we can provision them, we can deprovision, we can spin them up, we can spin them down. So the question is, should an agent be persistent? Should it always be waiting around to take on a task? Or should it just be brought up to do that task and then we bring it down? And there's actually some cost implications with this. There is a cost associated from an IT perspective of running agents. You don't have to run in a container or a pod or whatever, however you're doing that. The question is, there's a cost associated with this. CPU usage, you know, network traffic, data consumption, whatever that is. So if they're persistent, they could then be continually consuming resources? And do we want that or not? So this is the next question I pose. The final question I want to pose to everyone is, does our current IGA system, our identity governance and administration, does it do what we need? In other words, is it enough? And the reason I say that is if we think about if agents could be ephemeral, if they're supplementing workforces, if we need to spin them up, we could actually make thousands and thousands of these agents. There's actually multiplier numbers out there now that are all over the place, whether you need 5x agents to perform tax, if there's a number that says that if how many people you have in your organization, you're ultimately someday going to have 45x that in agents. Whatever, however you do your multiplier, we know there's going to be a lot of agents. And that means from a governance perspective, a lot of approvals, a lot of entitlements, a lot of annual validations. And if we think about the number of potential agents that should come out, the question is, will our current way that we handle identities, really around human identities, and if we're drawing some parallels here, is that enough? So these are the questions. These are the questions I am posing to everyone. And what I really would like you to do is, as mentioned, join in the conversation. Put some comments in. Tell me what you think about one or several or all of these questions. Other people can chime in and let's have a conversation. I do not want this to be a debate. It's not about right or wrong. It's not about whether it is or is not. It's really a conversation about where we think things are heading. So please engage, and I look forward to reading your comments.